Vitamin D, also known as the sunshine vitamin, is an essential nutrient for optimal health. This is because it comes with many functions that can influence our weight, cardiovascular health, hormones, and, you've guessed it, diabetes. Various experts suggest that vitamin D can have an impact on A1C levels, or blood glucose balance percentage. However, others are skeptical. Vitamin D may play a role in blood's health in cases of deficiency, but it can also be a byproduct of other vitamins or symptoms. So, what is the deal with vitamin D for blood glucose? And should you take a closer look at your own vitamin D levels? Don't go anywhere and keep watching. In this video, we'll break down the role of vitamin D and its deficiency on the body. We'll also look at the pros and cons of supplementing in this vitamin for your blood glucose. And we'll let you in on diabetic-friendly foods rich in vitamin D. So stick around. Before we get started, can you do us a favor? Like this video, ring the bell for future notifications, and make sure to subscribe to the Diabetics Talk channel for more help managing diabetes. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get 2 free gifts. And now, let's explore if vitamin D leads to lower A1C levels by breaking down the role of vitamin D in the diabetic body. Vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin that is converted by the body to support bone health, hormonal balance, and the unhealthy turnover of cells. Our body can synthesize vitamin D in 2 ways, through the sun's UV rays and through diet and food rich in vitamin D. When our body receives vitamin D, it converts it in our kidneys and liver to create the hormone calcitriol, which influences most every cell in our body. As a result, vitamin D can promote or limit the absorption of other nutrients such as calcium. So why is this important for diabetics? Well, diabetes means that your body's level of inflammation is more elevated. Through unbalanced blood glucose levels and insulin resistance, your body's natural ability to absorb nutrients properly is damaged. Diabetes can also slow down the regeneration and unhealthy turnovers of cells, which can, in time, have a negative ripple effect on your overall health. So, can vitamin D counterbalance these negative diabetic effects on the body? It depends. In the overall U.S. population, over 70% of adults have a vitamin D deficiency, and this number increases depending on your ethnicity and health. However, while studies have shown that vitamin D deficiency can increase the risk of heart attacks, autoimmune diseases, type 1 and type 2 diabetes, and diabetes complications, there is no scientific research that has found that diabetes makes you deficient. This suggests that while it is common to be deficient in vitamin D and more detrimental for diabetics, the condition itself is not a factor. Sadly, this means that while vitamin D may counterbalance negative health effects of diabetes, you're more likely to be deficient in it, and therefore your diabetic symptoms are aggravated. So, what does vitamin D deficiency entail? Being deficient in vitamin D means that you may experience recurring sickness and infections, fatigue, muscle aches, weight gain, mood changes, and insulin resistance. And what about blood glucose imbalance? Well, we're about to explore that, the positive and negative influences of vitamin D on A1C levels. A handful of experts were intrigued to understand whether or not vitamin D could improve insulin sensitivity, and as a result, blood glucose levels. In a study published by the European Journal of Endocrinology, researchers gave 5,000 IU units of vitamin D daily to 96 participants newly diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. After 6 months, it was observed that vitamin D supplementation increased insulin sensitivity and beta cell function, which fights off infection and boosts immunity. However, the same publication also compared those results with five other trials who used similar group of participants, dosage, and methods, and didn't find a correlation between vitamin D and blood glucose balance. A large study involving 2,423 participants with pre-diabetes gave 4,000 IU of vitamin D daily to half the participants, while the other half received a placebo. At that time, researchers noted that 80% of participants were not deficient in vitamin D. Participants were screened every 3 to 6 months for 2.5 years. At the end of the study, researchers found a small 2% difference in the prevalence of type 2 diabetes between both groups, which suggests that vitamin D intake has little influence on the development of insulin resistance and blood glucose imbalance when you're not deficient. As we can see, your levels of vitamin D are a vital component that influences other health metrics. If your body has enough vitamin D, it helps beta cells survive and increase insulin secretion, which is often attacked by diabetes. Maintaining the secretion of insulin is what will ultimately help your blood glucose balance and, as a result, lower your A1C levels. The studies focused on vitamin D supplementation and suggested that increasing the intake of vitamin D had limited effects. In short, supplementing when your vitamin D levels are regular is unnecessary and can even be detrimental in extreme cases. Blood levels of vitamin D should sit at a range of 20 to 50 nanograms per milliliter daily. A deficiency in vitamin D would be below 20 nanograms per milliliter. In some cases, vitamin D can sit up to 150 nanomoles per liter, which is considered a safe upper limit. Above this number, intake of vitamin D is considered toxic. So, as a diabetic, what should you do? All in all, it is recommended to first assess your levels of vitamin D. If you're deficient, supplementing to get into normal range is beneficial to limit side effects and improve insulin sensitivity. If you're in the normal range, it is not advised to take additional supplementation, as these will have little to no impact on your A1C levels and diabetic symptoms. Having plenty of protected sun exposure and adding vitamin D-rich food into your diet is a safe way to ensure you receive enough vitamin D without the need for supplementation. And we're about to break down the best foods for diabetics in vitamin D. But before we do, are you ready for a free gift? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free 1-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. Both gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. And now, let's find out the 4 best foods rich in vitamin D for diabetics, starting with number 4, mushrooms. Mushrooms are one of the best vegetarian sources of vitamin D. This is because, just like humans, mushrooms synthesize it from the sun's UV rays. Wild mushrooms such as hen of the woods, oyster mushrooms, and sulfur shelf mushrooms grow at the base of hardwood and oak trees and are a great source of vitamin D too. They contain up to 2,300 IU of vitamin D. In comparison, commercially grown mushrooms that are cultivated in the dark with UV lights contain 130 to 450 IU of vitamin D2. Research has noted that overall, mushrooms need UV sunlight to provide our bodies with a healthy amount of vitamin D. And when it comes to diabetes, mushrooms are also rich in antioxidants, which has shown to reduce oxidative stress and protect tissues against pro-inflammatory cytokine markers. Cytokine markers have a direct impact on diabetes, as it can increase insulin resistance and risks of diabetes complications. So by consuming mushrooms, not only do you get a healthy dose of dietary vitamin D, but it seems that you also reduce the inflammation triggering diabetic imbalances. So make sure to add more of it to your diet. If you feel confident enough to pick out wild mushrooms, go ahead. Otherwise, shop for a variety of mushrooms that have been grown under the sun. Number 3, eggs. Eggs, and particularly their yolk, are a good source of vitamin D. One typical egg yolk contains 37 IU of vitamin D, which equals 5% of the daily recommended intake. However, similarly to mushrooms, the vitamin D levels will vary depending on the sun exposure and feed of the hens. In a study involving three groups of 34 hens, researchers assigned each group to a location, indoor, outdoor, and a mix of indoor and outdoor. After 4 weeks, they found that the hens that roamed free in the sunlight delivered eggs with vitamin D levels that were 4 times higher than those who stayed indoors. Additionally, hens that are given a vitamin D-enriched feed can deliver eggs with up to 6,000 IU of vitamin D per yolk. Eggs also showed plenty of benefits for diabetes, as their nutritional content reduces fasting blood sugar and improves insulin sensitivity. All in all, eggs are another great vitamin D option to add to your diabetes-friendly diet, as long as you choose free-range or organic options. Number 2, fish. Fish is probably one of the best animal sources of vitamin D, and, big surprise, salmon makes the top of the list. On average, wild-caught salmon contains between 988 and 1300 IU of vitamin D. This equals an impressive 124% of the daily recommended intake. And farmed salmon can be beneficial as well, as Atlantic salmon contains around 526 IU of vitamin D, or 66% of the daily recommended intake. Herring, sardines, and tuna are other great sources of vitamin D. Fresh Atlantic herring delivers 216 IU of vitamin D, or about 27% of the daily recommended intake. Sardines contain 177 IU of vitamin D, and tuna about 268 IU. Data even suggests that a regular intake of vitamin D-rich food like salmon and other fish can regulate blood sugar. A 2019 study involving 680 women observed an important reduction in fasting blood glucose within the women who had regulated serum levels of vitamin D. These types of fish also contain omega-3 fatty acids, which has shown to be beneficial for diabetics, as it can lower blood lipids, decrease inflammation, and reduce risk of diabetes complications. So why not add more fish to your diet to naturally increase your vitamin D levels? And number 1 is soy. Because vitamin D is more commonly found in animal products, vegetarians and vegans are more at risk to be deficient in the vitamin. Consuming soy, or more specifically, soy milk, can be an additional vegetarian-friendly food that delivers some vitamin D. One cup of soy milk can contain up to 117 IU of vitamin D, or roughly 15% of the daily recommended intake. While this may not seem like much, soy milk is often nutritionally fortified with the dietary needs of vegetarians and vegans in mind. And that means that soy milk contains other beneficial vitamins and minerals for diabetics, such as antioxidants, polyphenols, including isoflavones. There is some evidence that soy's isoflavones can improve blood lipids, increase insulin sensitivity, and balance blood glucose levels. A review of 17 studies on menopausal women found that soy isoflavones specifically reduced fasting blood sugar and insulin resistance. So while soy can be beneficial to increase your intake of vitamin D and regulate your blood sugar, it is worth mentioning that not all soy products are created equal. Certain products are more processed than others and can deliver less nutrients and vitamin D. So if you'd like to increase your vitamin D intake with soy milk, make sure to choose the most natural option. All in all, we've seen that vitamin D plays a supportive role for our body, but the question remains, can taking vitamin D lead to lower A1C levels? Yes, but only if you are deficient in vitamin D. A deficiency in vitamin D can result in many downsides, including unbalanced blood glucose, but if your vitamin D levels are normal as it is, there is no benefit to supplementing more. All in all, keeping your vitamin D levels in a healthy range is essential to keep your insulin resistance and blood glucose in check. And you can do that mainly with sunlight and food rich in vitamin D, unless otherwise recommended by your doctor. And there you have it. What fact has surprised you about vitamin D? Share your thoughts with a fellow diabetic in the comments section below. And before you leave, make sure to claim your free gifts by clicking on the link in the description box below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell button for more Diabetics Talk. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.